Hi, welcome to this ArcLinux B Plasma system. The people who are new to ArcLinux will not know that I've made a promise on this particular SSD to never ever do anything without showing every little bit of change I've made to it. So this is an SSD where everything has been recorded. The one thing I did not record just now is me logging into Dropbox and me logging into Discord, but that's just login, password, done. So there is a question about Plasma, and I thought let's put this SSD back in and let's continue there, because there's another thing that people keep saying and it's just untrue, and I try to break all these false information about Arch Linux that you need to update daily, otherwise it breaks your system and stuff like that. So I have videos, you'll see that online, that there are computers that have not been touched like 8 months, and then we just update and everything is fine. So here again, let's have a look how old it is. When you type in last, you can see how many times and how old your SSD is. So at some point in time, I made the SSD November the 7th, and we did this Plasma challenge. So, okay, let's do this. So all the time use Plasma. And we have made lots and lots of videos about all the tips and the tweaks and how to go about with this new desktop, okay? So November 9th, we go up 10th, so a lot of videos, but at some point we said, okay, let's develop this and that. So the SSD is put aside. And then a jump from January to March, no problem at all. And we just update our system and move on. Here a jump from March to June, no problem in updating. And we are now jumping from June the 12th to July the 29th. So more than a month ago and a half almost, right? So that's the point of the video, also to convince you guys, hey, when you go for Arch Linux, which is basically right, Arch Linux is based on Arch Linux, so it gets the same wins, bad wins, saying it's not stable or whatever, it breaks and you need to update it all the time. All the things you hear are rubbish. So I convince you with videos, facts and figures. And that's why you see sometimes just me updating a system and going over elements where you should take a look at, but it's just updating, it's okay. That's what I call rolling. Don't install it, reinstall it, just keep updating. So let's do that and answer a question of a user on the forum. So if you have issues, put them on the forum. Often they end up in a video just like this. I'm gonna get rid of my Conky. A Super C is working, and that's this Super, is it already here? Desktop system monitor on and off, Conky toggle. So that's the thing that does this Conky here, but it all depends. Conkies, you know by now probably that it all depends on what desktop manager you're working. You should dive into the code and add some lines to it or change some lines to it so that it's actually sticking to your desktop, not floating above it and stuff like that. So updating, Control T, normal procedure is update. This is going to be Arch Linux and Arch Linux, okay? So he's going to get it. It might be a good idea after all this time to ask the system, hey, do check out if the reference, if the fastest Arch Linux server is still the fastest Arch server. I mean by that the Arch Linux server world should be around, I don't know, 30, 40, 50 servers. So it depends where you live. And at this point in time, this alias mirror is going to check around in the world. Hey, we still have in this version still two mirrors. So we need to fix that as well, I see. There's mirror A and mirror D. So we have here only two of them, but it worked already. And it's going to check out all the Arch Linux servers, not Arco, Arch Linux servers. And now, I hope, of course, I get a faster update. That's also important. So, go back. I saw some nice figures. I want to share that information here. Look at these numbers, right? These are fast numbers. This means that the update is gonna last less. So, updating the system, it can be that you need to install the keyring first. So if you get issues with keyring, there is something called Arch Linux keyring. And then you just update that one first. And then everything will be installing. So that's an important one. Arch Linux keyring, that's the key to open the door. Without this key, the package says, I won't install. Okay, so Arch Linux keyring first then. If you get issues, we don't see issues, everything is installing. But I thought just put the tip already in the video. So we have all these nice things with the wobbly on, I see. So these are all settings you can do in Plasma. Now I was taking a picture earlier on with a control print screen. I thought I was making some kind of progress with a pop-up or something to make screenshots. And in making a screenshot, that's what I would have typed, and it is working. But you should start learning the words, and I should too. And it's actually called Spectacle, because Spectacle is the screenshot capture utility in Plasma. So if I want to take a picture, it's going to take one already. So it can do a full screen, a current screen, active window, window on the cursor, rectangular. So, and then you decide, like for instance, let's decide active window, take a new screenshot, and you get this thing. Then it's not saved. You can copy to the clipboard, Control C, Control V later on. Some tools, configure, so take new screenshots, etc., etc. So a lot of things you can do. You can save it at some place. I can also say to save it as GPG, which is for me on websites much better. So I can set this as well. So, well, since we're changing this, let's continue with Spectacle while it's updating anyway. So if I do another screenshot, but I don't have a keyboard shortcut yet. So I'm wondering, can I make keyboard shortcuts, right? Keyboard shortcuts, they are in here, but they're not what I thought that would be. So I'm gonna go to my settings and see if I have already Arch Linux keyboard shortcuts. They are, let me think again, shortcuts. Let's open this one. Custom shortcuts, like I thought. We have our own little folder or group where everything is inside. You see, all our keyboards that we've made in the past are here, but Spectacle is not. Okay, so this Spectacle thing, how does it work? I don't know. Mount Spectacle is finished here, is as you see here. So let's kick started again with a PKSYUA, and all these things, this list is coming from AUR, and that's all good, they can install. So we'll just wait for that as well. You go there, and I'm gonna type Spectacle minus H. So what can I do? I can ask the author, the license, full screen, the current, active window, transitional region, GUI, GUI. That's the one I want, actually, I think. Let's try. I want, when I press the button, get this. Okay, so that's good. I want Spectacle minus G, and all the rest is okay. So custom shortcuts, edit, new, global shortcut, command URL, trigger. Let's do a control print screen. Action should be spectacle minus G, please. Get away, because I need to press the button here. Let's apply. So this should be in control print screen. And I have my, what I thought I was going to get when I press this button, and we can take our decisions later on. current screen, takes new screenshot. That's this one. Is it going to save it as GPG? Unable to create IO slave, Kalasha says, error launching things. Well, yeah, maybe we should reboot, you know? Good idea. So if you're updating, well, certainly with 1 month in between, month and a half almost, we'll probably get a new kernel and all that. A lot of stuff has changed in Plasma. We're on 5.2.3, I think. So, lots of kernels have passed since then. So let's wait for this Vivaldi to update and all that. So I do want to check my spectacle settings a little bit more. What can I do more? So tools, open screenshot folder, print record screen. We can do that like that. Focal screen, haven't tried that. Okay. Export, share, send to device. Imgur is also something I use. But as you see, it's still the same thing. We need to probably reboot. I'm not sure. Send to Bluetooth, a lot of things that are in here that other systems, desktops, I mean, then really don't have. It's really full-fledged desktop that has it all. And it all depends if you like that or not. Quit after save or copy. Might be a good trick as well. If you take a new screenshot and you save it, if you can later on, yes, we know, I'll reboot you. So the settings, I can check this one as well. Press screenshots, take a new open spectacle, return, open a new spectacle window. That's something we can do as well. Press screenshot key 2. Okay, let's try that. Print screen, not doing anything, but it's time to reboot. So since this is a video, I have to cut it in two. And I'll see you later.